Hello friends, this is Mr. Rahul Honkolas, Assistant Professor and Workshop Superintendent from Inbinole Sinhagad College of Engineering. I am having total 12 years of teaching experience and my qualification is Mechanical Design Engineering. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about the different numericals based in the chapter of Testing and Performance of IC Engine. In the last video, we already discussed about the heat balance sheet. Now, here we start with the first variety of the problem, that is the trial reading on 4-stroke single cylinder engine are trial duration 30 minute, oil consumed is equal to 4 liter per minute, calorific value is equal to 43 megajoule per kg, specific gravity of fuel is equal to 0.8, indicator diagram area is equal to 8.5 centimeter square. The length of the diagram is equal to 8.5 cm. Units are very important over here, so concentrate on the unit. Spring constant is equal to 5.5 bar per cm. The brake load is equal to 150 kg. Then spring balance is equal to 20 kg. Effective brake wheel diameter is equal to 1.5 meter. Then speed is equal to 200 rpm. Cylinder diameter is equal to 30 cm. Stroke is equal to 45 cm. Jacket cooling water is equal to 10 kg per minute. Temperature rise is given, that is equal to 36 degree Celsius. And specific gravity of the fuel oil is given 0.8. So with the help of this, we can calculate the density of fuel, that is nothing but multiply by 1800 kg per meter cube. Now in this case, with the help of this given data, we have to calculate the brake power, indicated power, mechanical efficiency, brake specific fuel consumption, then indicated thermal efficiency, brake thermal efficiency, and heat carried away by coolant. Now here we can rewrite the given data. The calorific value is given in terms of megajoule, so convert it into kilojoule, that is multiplying by 10^3 kilojoule per kg. Then the loads are given, one is 150 kg and another one is 20 kg, so we can write in terms of W1 and W2, that is 150 kg, and the second one, that is 20 kg. Then the value of N is equal to 200 rpm, then the diameter is equal to 30 cm, then the stroke length is 45 cm, mass of cooling water is equal to 10 kg per minute, the temperature rise is given, that is 36 degrees Celsius, means T2 minus T1, the rise is nothing but the higher temperature minus the lower temperature, so we can write directly 36 degrees Celsius, the temperature rise. Then the number of cylinder, this is a single cylinder engine, so the value of N is equal to 1. Then the effective brake wheel diameter, let us consider capital D, and this value is given over here, that is equal to 1.5 meter. Then we can calculate the cylinder area with the help of the formula pi by 4 d square. The cylinder diameter is given, that is a 30 cm, so convert it into meter and get the answer of area pi by 4 into small d square, that is equal to 0.071 meter square. Then the first one, we are going to calculate the first one, that is brake power. Now here we can calculate the brake power with the help of the formula 2 pi nt by 60 into 1000 in terms of kilowatt. To get the value of torque, we have the formula torque is equal to W into R. R is nothing but the diameter by 2. The load is given in terms of W1 and W2, so we can get W1 minus W2, and load is given in kg, so convert it into Newton by multiplying 9.81, and the diameter of brake wheel is given 1.5, so we can get the radius by divided by 2. So this way we can calculate the torque is equal to 956.48 Newton meter. So put the value of torque in the brake power equation, and finally we can get the brake power is 20.03 kilowatt. Then similarly, the second calculation is of indicated power. We have the formula indicated power is equal to N into P M I into L into A into N into K into 10 divided by 6. To calculate the PMI, that is the mean indicated pressure, first in this formula we have the formula area of the diagram divided by length of the diagram into spring constant. The area of the diagram is given in the problem, that is 8.5 cm square, and the length of the diagram is given in the problem, that is 8.5 cm, and spring constant is also given, that is 5.5 bar per cm. Now the area of the diagram, convert the area of the diagram centimeter square to meter square by multiplying 10^-4, and similarly the spring constant is also given bar per centimeter converted into meter by multiplying 10 raised to minus 2, and a length of the diagram is again given in centimeters, so converted into meter, that is into 10 raised to minus 2, and then we can get the value of PMI is 5.5 bar. If you see the unit conversion, you can see or you can check the PMI value, it should be in 5.5 bar. So this way we can calculate the indicated power, put all these values in indicated power formula, where the value of K, that is for 4-stroke engine, the value of K is 4-stroke engine is 1/2, and for 2-stroke engine is 1. So here is a 4-stroke engine, so we can put the value of K is 1/2 and put all the values and get the value of indicated power is equal to 29.29 kilowatt. The third one, that is the mechanical efficiency, we can get the mechanical efficiency by this formula, BP by IP into 100, that is the brake power by indicated power into 100, and we have the mechanical efficiency is 0.684 into 100, that is 68.4%. Then BSFC, brake specific fuel consumption, to calculate this we have the formula mass of fuel into brake power divided by brake power in kg per kilowatt hour. So initially we have to calculate first mass of fuel in kg per hour, so its formula is oil consumed per liter divided by duration into density of fuel. The specific gravity is given in the problem, that is 0.8, so we can calculate the density, that is 800 kg per meter cube. Oil consumed per liter, that is very important. So the oil consumed per liter is equal to 1 liter is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. So convert this thing in terms of liter. So 4 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by the duration is 30 minutes, converted into per hour, so divided by 60 into the density of fuel is 800. So we can calculate the MF is equal to 6.4 kg per hour. So likewise, we can get the value of BSFC by putting the value of MF in the BSFC formula, and the value of BSFC is 0.32 kg per kilowatt hour. Then the indicated thermal efficiency, the next one, we have the formula IP divided by MF into calorific value multiply by 3600. How here we are taking this 3600? We'll understand with the help of the unit conversion. Indicated power is given in kilowatt, mass of fuel in kg per hour, then calorific value is kilojoule per kg. Kg will get cancelled. The kilowatt we can write kilojoule per second, and the remaining things, that is the kilojoule per second into that hour divided by kilojoule. Kilojoule will get cancelled, and remaining is hour per second. Hour is nothing but 3600 seconds by second. So here we have to multiply this equation or this formula by 3600, and we can get the indicated thermal efficiency 38%. Similar way, we can calculate the brake thermal efficiency by multiplying 3600, and we have the 26.35% brake thermal efficiency. Then the next one, heat carried away by coolant, we have the formula mass of water into specific heat of water into the temperature rise, that is T2 minus T1, and we have the value is 1509.8 kilojoule per minute. Okay, here we complete the solution of this problem. Here we stop. We'll see in the next video the next problem. Thank you.